Hi friends, it's Sara here and welcome back to the third episode of the Webflow 101 course. If you missed the first two episodes, then you can find the link in the description. So today we're gonna make our website responsive, add links and share it with the world. So if you're new here, consider subscribing so you can get notified every time the next video comes out. Okay, done? Yeah, now let's get ready for this video. During the previous episode, we designed this in Webflow, and today we're gonna learn how to use breakpoints, add links, and finally we're gonna launch our website. Okay, now let's start from breakpoints. As you can see here, we've got some different breakpoints, and we can see that our layout doesn't work correctly on smaller devices, so we're gonna adjust this and let's say we're gonna give max width of 100%. We can see that the layout already works much better. On small devices, maybe we can reduce the padding to 1 rem, I think. Yeah, I think it works. The icons are kind of a bit smaller. I'm not sure how to solve this. Maybe we can just reduce the padding. Yes, it works. And we can also make this justify space around. Yes, I think it works. Okay, we can also add breakpoints. For example, we can add this breakpoints that is for larger devices. In this case, I like to set the section to be 100% PH, which means it's gonna take the full half of the page. And every time, if you wanna change an element, a property, and apply across all breakpoints, just make sure you are on the desktop view. Otherwise, you're gonna need to do this again. I've done this mistake myself several times, but hopefully you're gonna learn from my experience. Okay, now we're gonna add our links. So let's see. New video. I'm gonna find my YouTube channel. Just copy and paste the link in this way. You click on this icon and you can add the URL. You can also open up in a new tab or just leave as it is. I'm gonna add a few examples. Okay, this is the URL of my latest video that will be replaced by this one, I guess. Okay, we can do the same with social links. Just do the same thing. Okay, now we can test if the buttons work simply by clicking on them. Yep. Okay, great, nice. Now let's see again if it works on all devices. And now we're finally launched our website. We click on publish here and we publish to select domain. And our website is live. Can you believe, just in a few simple clicks, our website is live and everyone can see it. The only thing is that we can't have our custom domain as we're using the free plan. We also have the Webflow icon at the bottom. But if you think you want to expand this website and have your own domain, you can always upgrade. By clicking on custom domain here, you can see all the different plans that Webflow offers. But if you're simply looking for a link to add to your social media, just I think that the free plan works well. We also don't need to create too many pages, and one is enough. Okay, yeah, I think that's it for today. And if you want to see this website, you can connect with me on Instagram, because I'm going to leave it for a while. I am saretta.ux, and yeah, I'll see you there. In the next episode, we are going to look at resources, templates, and courses that can help you learn all you need to know about Webflow. If you found this tutorial helpful, I'd be super happy if you click on the subscribe button, if you haven't done yet. Like this video and share it with your friends, as it really helps to support my channel. Alright, thank you for sticking around, and I'll see you in the next episode. Ciao!